This isn't a job bath. It's a bloodbath.
14 non-trepreneurs have come to London in search of a job.
Listen, I was bootlegging Tamagotchis when Prince Andrew could still sweat.
Retired ventriloquist Doll Baron Sugar is offering one of them the chance to win a soul.
Can I pitch? I'm the sales bitch.
I've got underlying wealth conditions.
Ich habe die SS zum Eiffel geführt.
So I pulled out my Uzi and said, fill up the bags.
I'm not the honey monster. I'm the money monster.
You're fired. You're fired. Put away the gack, Michael. You're fired.
This week's task is purchasing.
I need you to source 10 essential items for tackling a pandemic.
The teams must do this with as little transparency as possible, ideally from friends.
Hi, underclasses! Have any of yous got a test and trace system that doesn't work?
Hiya, Pet! Have you got any of that PPE?
But for a third week in a row, Team Net Worth refused to take part because they don't understand science.
Well, they predicted a plague of locusts and all we got was 120,000 dead people.
Over on Team Excess Mortality, bivalve mollusk Michael Gove looks like he might have made a breakthrough.
200 grand for a packet of Froobs, is that right?
Yes, Mr. Gove.
Very reasonable.
And as the day draws to a close, Jacob finally secures a deal.
37 billion and a can of iron brew. Bargain.
Look, I bought a hard hat.
I got an enamel badge.
We've absolutely nailed it.
But back in the boardroom, Duke Sugar is looking over the results.
Excess Mortality bought 0 functioning items, giving them a net loss of 40 billion.
And Team Net Worth?
They're still self-interested shits, Your Grace.
Right, the Tories edge it.
But it was underwear thief and voicemail enthusiast Piers Morgan who was found to have breached his restraining order.
Piers, you're not stalking Meghan, are you?
Have you hacked my phone?
You're fired.